gentlemen, welcome to the RFUEA Grounds for Kenya Cup Match Day 5 encounter pitting KCB against Resolution Impala Saracens. Helping me out with commentary and analysis is a very able team of Dan Otieno, who will be joining me later. But for now, I am joined by Biko Adema, with whom we're just going to have a small conversation about this match. Biko, first of all, welcome.
Yeah, thank you, Mike. Thanks for having me today. I'm glad about this, and I'm ready to rumble.
Well, just looking at the squads, your take on the squads, both KCB and Impala.
Well, you know, okay, both these teams, they're looking very strong. Both teams have had excellent past games. Impala, however, coming from a loss last weekend versus Strathmore. And, you know, obviously, KCB looking on form at the moment, beating teams, for example, against Machine 50-15. The previous weekend, 60-10. So KCB are looking really strong. And we know they're powerful players. I mean, we have the likes of we have John Ahenda, Moses Amusala. Those are very big, strong boys. Curtis Lilako, you know.
Well, yes, Biko, thank you for that. And also, just looking at Impala, they're currently lying in ninth place, not where they would want to be after a recent run of, I wouldn't say bad form, because they have actually expressed themselves very well in all the games they've played, just been unlucky to lose two games. They lie ninth. You just feel that today's game is going to be an explosive encounter.
Yes, I think this is going to be one of the games, you know, to look out for this weekend. Both teams are looking ready and rearing to go. I think it's really going to be a very interesting encounter. The backs of Impala are looking very explosive, very, very skillful, very on point, you know, and I would like to see the flair from guys like Samuel Liech, Nyandigisi coming through. You know, those are the players to watch out in that team. So yeah, it's going to be a good one.
Exactly, Biko. Thank you very much. And in our screen there, we just see both teams lining up, preparing to get onto the pitch. We can see a section of the fans who have gathered here at the RFUEA ground. Remember, there will be a double header, because after the KCB Impala match, we will have Queens play against Nondies in the 4 p.m. kickoff. And just looking quickly, there is the Impala lineup: Jose Angesa, Edgar Obino, Robert Kwea, Eric Kere, Eric Opondo, Joel Omer, Felix Okari, Duncan Ekasi, the captain, the veteran Moses Kola slots in at halfback. Number 10 is Anthony Nyandigisi, 11 Piers Shiundu, 12 Jeffrey Anampiu, 13 Robert Odhiambo, 14 Quinto Ongo, and 15 is Sammy Oliech. Well, the crowd's continuing to build up here today, and Biko, once again, what do you think will be the flashpoints of this match?
It's going to be a closely contested game, but I think, well, when I look at the forwards from KCB, the KCB forwards, they look very strong, and I think they're going to give a good show today. But the real battle will be amongst the backs. And it's interesting to see that Anthony Nyandigisi is now playing at number 10 this weekend. I know he's played in that position before, but let's see how he does today.
Probably could be the ace up Impala's sleeve. We never know. As the teams just step on to the pitch, getting into that pre-match huddle that Biko Adema knows only too well about. Biko, what do you think could be going on in their heads at this point in time?
You know, the butterflies are always there before any game, man. Even I've always told guys, even if you put me against to play against the under 13 team and I face them, even stand up, line up against them in the tunnel, I'll still feel those butterflies. You know, before any game, you always feel that as a rugby player, and you know, it's just the jitters. But as soon as you get your hands on the ball, it quickly goes away.
Thank you very much, Biko, and we'll talk again at halftime. Joining me for commentary in this match will be Dan Otieno. And in our picture there is the center referee, Andrew Karani, one of the brighter referees in Kenya, one of the younger talents, the ones replacing the more experienced likes of Raymond Ruru and Godwin Karuga. The match gets underway there. Kickoff from Impala deep into KCB territory, fielded by John Ahenda, embarks on a run. Felix Wanjala playing it to Billy Sabwa. boots it out into touch. We've done barely 20 seconds of the game. Maybe, Dan, a chance for you to get your vocal cords in action.
Well, thank you very much, Mike. It's actually very good to be here. Thank you so much for inviting me. Once again, welcome everybody to Match Day 5 of the Kenya Cup right here at the RFUEA Grounds on Jamhuri Day. Happy Jamhuri Day, everybody. And underway on your screen, we have the first line out of the game, to Impala in the red and white against KCB in their classic green. Doesn't look like it happened too well, went Impala's way on that one. It's come back. KCB looking very strong in the forwards. Just as Biko had said, they do have very strong forwards, very solid forwards. It is not going to be a pushover game for either side. Impala coming from a loss to Strathmore last weekend, not very happy about that. And they did actually get a chance to watch KCB's game, so they are on their toes. Let's expect a lot more from their backline this weekend, especially with players like Pius Yundu, especially at 11, Anthony Nyandigizi at 10. And we have actually what we expected to see last weekend happening this weekend in Impala's backline, with Robert Aringo coming in at 13.
Well, maybe just to ask, since I wasn't at that game, what did Robert Aringo do last weekend that has merited him making the first 15 for this match?
Last weekend, I think one of their tactics was trying to get an impact bench to come in the second half. That didn't look like it was happening as it was intended, being as that Strathmore had the lead of the game since the beginning. But he did make some effect, made some very big runs. He saw the gaps, he saw the weaknesses. And this weekend, I think it would be an opportunity for them to capitalize on his strength and his focus right now, earlier on in the game, as opposed to the second half, instead of playing a catch-up game.
Exactly.
There we have a line out by Impala. They seem to win that one. A bit scrappy. Moses Kola shifting it off to Anthony Nyandigizi. And there we go, straight to Robert Aringo, who's very strong in the tackle. Never backs down very easy. Going in for the ruck. Seems to be sealed over. Well, the breakdown rules of the game are something that a lot of players this season are going to have to actually study, sit down and watch out for. Because a lot of players seem to make the same errors over and over, and they seem to forget that the game is evolving and it changes with every season.
Anthony Nyandigisi's penalty, failing to find touch into the hands of KCB fullback Isao Otieno, who just returns the favor and relieves his side of pressure. But this is Quinto Ongo in possession for Impala, embarking on a run, but just running into KCB players there. The mall forms. Impala looking imperious at this point in time. Can just see in our picture there, KCB scrummy Felix Wanjala just barking the orders as the advantage swings the way of the Bankers. Remember, KCB come into this fixture lying third on the Kenya Cup table. They've won four games, all four games that they've played. They've scored 31 against. They've collected three bonus points. They are on 19 points. Impala lie ninth on the log, two wins from four matches. They've also lost two matches. They've picked up three bonus points, a total of 11 points. Play continues here.
Now, that didn't seem too good from Impala on the scrummage. The breakaways didn't exactly do their job as intended. There was a little bit too much time for KCB to get the ball away on that one. But let's hope for a better continuation of the game for Impala. As they press up, their line speed seems very good, trying to maintain the distance of the gain line. There we have John Ahenda taking the ball in to Anthony Nyandigizi. Managed to bring him down just...
And just playing it there to Edwin Otieno. Once again, Wanjala just trying to dictate play there for KCB. They lose the ball on the tackle and the possession, swinging back to Impala.
Looking too good for Nyandigizi. Only 4 minutes into the game, seems to have taken a bit of a hard hit there from John Ahenda. Of course, he does have one of the reputations in Kenya for one of the most ruthless forwards.
And it's great to see players like John Ahenda, players like Moses Kola still playing this game. These guys were on top of their game many years ago. And to see them still play at this high level, the highest level of Kenyan club rugby, is indeed a very encouraging sight.
It is very encouraging, especially one of the most encouraging sights I've seen this season is seeing players like Namkos. Like Namkos Simeo coming back, and that was actually very encouraging. 2 years, is it 2 or 3 years out?
It was close to 3 years out.
Close to 3 years out with a dismal knee injury during the Super Series. And he's made his comeback. There we have Pius Shiundu fighting for the ball, establishing his territory.
Yeah,
of course, Kifaru UAP Kifaru Bamburi Rugby Super Series champion, going up against, of course, an old foe, Alan Omuka, who faced off against him in the finals.
Well, Shiundu was back home, just covering. Remember, his fullback had joined the attack when KCB just opted to boot the ball and just get rid of the pressure that Impala had been piling on them. It is a line out deep in Impala territory. What can they do from this? They somehow retain possession. This is Robert Aringo.
Excellent reaction from Aringo on that one.
And Igisi straight to Darwin Mukidza.
Now, as we know, Darwin Mukidza loves to run the ball down the middle of the pitch, fearing absolutely no one, catching Moses Kola off guard. He stuck the wrong shoulder in. As we do know, if you do stick the wrong shoulder in on the wrong side, you will go down easier than expected. Slight correction there, ladies and gentlemen. In jersey number 20 in the forward pack, we have Warren Nyanjom, not Robert Aringo. Robert Aringo is in jersey number 13 in the back line. Of course, we have been known to see him in the forwards at back row, but he seems to prefer playing in the centers.
True indeed. And just for your information, Warren Nyanjom, Kenya under 19 international. He was part of the squad that won the inaugural Kenya under 19. Let me take that again. He was part of the squad that won the inaugural Elgon Cup under 19 competition this year, beating Uganda on aggregate. KCB just retaining possession from this line out and Mole. That's Curtis Lilako who breaks.
Curtis Lilako, Kenya 15's international, seems to have gone over. And there we have it. First on the scoreboard, KCB. KCB with the first try of the game, very early in the game. Here it is again, Curtis Lilako just breaking from the mall, taking on Nyandikisi, feeling absolutely nothing, no regard for the defensive line, and crossing the line. There we have on the Impala bench. Good to see Matthew Musalia back after his long stint away after playing for Mean Machine. Here we have Dawun Mukidza just about to take the conversion. And it's good to see some of the progression in the game over the years. A lot more time taken for conversions, rather the practice of taking conversions. And the flags go up. It's good right between the posts. Here we have the first conversion of the game is good. Current scores of the game, KCB 7, Impala 0. 9 minutes into the game. Kenya Cup Match Day 5 right here at the RFUEA Grounds on Jamhuri Day, ladies and gentlemen. Kicking off, Anthony Nyandigisi sends it deep. There we have John Ahende taking it, looking for the space, taking it in not too hard at the moment. Of course, you can see that they're trying to conserve some energy. Impala managed to win it back. Nyanjom taking it strong, almost isolated himself. That ball went out quick. Moses Kola swings it wide to Robert Aringo, who seems to have run into a little bit of trouble with the bankers. Darwin Mukidza not letting that one go. And the bankers have it back, sending it all the way back, forcing.
That was Billy Isabwa just booting it deep and forcing Quinto Ongo to turn and return the ball back, we have both Issa Otieno, who knocks on what seemed like a straightforward catch.
Seemed like a straightforward catch. Of course, we also have to take into account the factor of wind with the current weather these days. It is sunny, but it is not as hot as we'd expect it to be. But he should have taken a few steps towards the ball. You are right. That was a very straightforward catch. Should have taken a few steps towards the ball, probably caught it, and ended up somewhere probably near just before the halfway.
Yeah. Well, also, Dan, you'd probably think that with the sun overhead, he could probably have been unsighted by the rays of the sun. But remember, when you're playing in any position, you need to be aware of your surroundings. That's why you're put in that position in the first place.
Absolutely. There are different factors that are... KCB completely walking over that one. Very happy about that one. Impala unable to consolidate their scrummages at the moment. Let's hope that they'll be able to warm up and provide a little bit more of a contest as the game proceeds. Going back in for the scrummage, in jersey number 6 for Impala, on the blind side, Joel Omer. Very disruptive in the breakdown, very aggressive, excellent tackler. Has been at Impala for as long as I can remember. KCB win that one and boot it all the way back. As we see Impala managing to retrieve that one. Impala looking good on the run. Their back line is very strong at the moment. And I think a lot of that has to be accredited to the current regime that they are, the current training program that they're going on, that they're using at the moment. Duncan Ekasi managing to pull that one away.
And they forced the infringement of KCB.
Of course,
but
KCB
at the same time, we can see two Impala players down. Probably the impact of a very high intensity at the beginning of this match.
Absolutely. And in last week's game, I noticed that Impala were sort of unable to keep up with the intensity of Strathmore. Of course, as we do know, Strathmore is one of the fittest sides that have ever graced Kenya rugby. And but Impala were able to fight back at some point. Let's just hope that they're able to settle quicker into this game. Moses Kola doing what he does best with that excellent right boot.
Moses Kola is a goal kicker of notable repute. And he does the job.
So that's a good look for Impala, putting themselves on the scoreboard with 13 minutes into the game. Current scores, KCB 7. Impala, Resolution Impala Saracens now at 3. KCB getting ready to kick off. Let's remember that KCB are currently third in the Kenya Cup standings. Of course, scoring a massive massive point difference between them and Impala, who are ninth at the moment. KCB, 19 points, who are tied with Nakuru RFC. But of course, the intricacies of little things such as bonus points are what separate that. There we have what seems to be a very good boot, but unfortunately right into the hands of the KCB players, who seem to want to run this one very hard. Alan Omuka going straight past. KCB seem to be using the quick ruck. Very strong on his feet, has managed to come off that one. KCB are using the quick ruck in this one, if you watch carefully, not taking too much time, managing to spread the ball pretty wide, but the back line of Impala is extremely, extremely solid on their defense, and not wasting any time to get there, cutting off any signs of an overlap. Their line speed is looking very excellent, especially within their own half. There we have, again, Another.
Okay. You need a seat or something?
No, I'll just sit.
Ah, okay. Yeah, I'll consult you a lot.
I think what they want to do is maximize on their strong point at the moment and use their forwards for them more. The points, of course, every last point does matter at this particular in every game, especially earlier on. The first 20 minutes determines who is the stronger, who is more focused, who knows what they're going to get at better. But right now, I think what KCB want to do is maximize on their maul situation, which it looks like they're going to go in for, because you can see they're all in at the 5 yard. And Impala seem ready for that, looking to only lift one jumper at the 5, contest only at the 2 ball, which is of course very conventional. But we also have to keep in mind that Impala this season have shown signs of incredible improvement at the line out, and also just, you know, playing on the borderline of the rules of the game when it comes to the line out. And if you're not alert, they will manage to get this one back. So here we go. Ball going up. KCB have it. Look, Impala not mauling. No maul formed. And there we have it. No maul was formed. There was absolutely no contact. But Impala. Oh, there we have the contact in jersey number 5, which constituted the maul. So very good look, therefore. For KCB. Impala also did play that one very cleverly. Of course, as we do know, if there is no opposition granted to the attacking team on the maul, it cannot constitute as a maul, and that would have not been a try in any way. It would have been a penalty straight back to Impala. But they managed to grab hold of Eric Kopondo just at the last minute, which constituted contact and resistance. And there they have it. Awaiting the conversion. And the conversion is good. Taking their points to 14. KCB currently at 14, Impala at 3. 18 minutes into the game. Just a little bit of information on this game. Tight head Moses Amusala has returned to the KCB front row. He's been absent for a while. And Resolution Impala Saracens are very aware of this, actually. Moses Amusala actually takes the place of George Asin, who he managed to put on the bench. Once again, another scrummage that we have. Captain Curtis Lilako just giving slight instructions. Here we have it off the kickoff. And KCB put it in. Impala seeming to want to wheel it. KCB seem to have locked themselves in perfectly for that one. Excellent strategy on that one. Taken very well.
You know, just looking at what's happening in this game, KCB not allowing Impala any breathing space when Impala are on the ball. An example, a few moments ago when Samuel Lietch retrieved that high ball from Billy Isabua, he would usually embark on a searching run, but he's finding men ready to tackle him and just cut down his flow.
Absolutely. He gets back on his feet from the air and has absolutely no space to move. Trying to step and look for the space, there's absolutely nowhere to go. He is forced to take the contact. And subsequently, in a situation like this where KCB have now managed to maintain possession.
This is Amusala just taking it again into contact and gaining 2 or 3 yards for KCB. This is Felix Wanjala now to Billy Isabua. Steps
Billy Isabua
and again.
Seeing the gap, not able to execute right through it.
This is Lilako, who's having a storming first half so far.
Two tries with under 20 minutes. Duncan Nkasi just managing to get a hand on it there.
You know, Dan, one interesting feature of this game is the halfback competition. It's between two former Kenya internationals, between Moses Kola and Felix Wanjala. And at one time, Moses Kola was a starting scrum half for the Kenya 15s. Felix Wanjala was his substitute. It's interesting to see them renew their acquaintance again.
Absolutely, especially in a situation like this. Match day five right here at the RFUEA grounds. Who would have known that Moses Kola would be making a return to the game so strong? The level of impact that he has in the Impala squad is just as what it used to be back in the day. And of course, you had the greater privilege of playing with him for a long, playing against him and with him for a longer period of time than I did.
Yeah, but things do change. Hair loss happens. You put on weight. Moses Kola has just stayed the same, man.
I think you should probably consult him for the Fountain of Youth on that one.
I sure will after this game. You can see a man down on the Impala side.
Jesse Ngesa not looking too good for him.
Well, that's a massive boot from Anthony Nyandigisi. Remember, Impala need to stay alive in this game. You'd rather keep close than let the scores slide away and start playing catch-up. Because the trouble sometimes, Dan, with playing catch-up is that your concentration tends to slip, you become erratic, and you open yourself up to a lot more.
The desperation, exactly. And that's the exact kind of game that Impala played last weekend versus Strathmore. And Strathmore just kept their heads and kept on playing the rugby that they played with the high intensity that they did. KCB managing to steal that one away.
Zala Nomuka, who's going to be forced to kick, and he does kick. It was
very
necessary.
Uncharacteristic from Alan Nomuka to see him kicking.
But it was necessary to just relieve the pressure on his side. And this is Samuel Lech, the potential danger man for me, if you ask me, on the Impala side.
And I would say that KCB are very, 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 very erratic play there. Not a very good decision from Robert Quare. Passing forward to Jesse Ngesa. Well, especially in the front row, he should have just taken the contact, in my opinion. Not a very good show there, especially with the first 20 minutes gone in the game. KCB leading 14 to Impala's 3. Right now, the best thing that Impala can do is keep their mental alive, keep their heads up, not panic and not act erratically. KCB, scrum. Impala shoving. KCB managed to lock it in. Duncan Akasi on that one. Just let go of the tackle at the last second. Here we have John Ahenda taking it in very strong. Covered by his forwards. Felix Wanjala booting it deep. And Pius Shiundu was able to get a hand on that one. Taking it up. Just not into the space as he intended. But he is on it. Alan Omuka with a massive handoff. Very famous for that. Unfortunately, some scrappy play has taken that one into touch. Let's see if we can get a replay on that one. The massive palm from Alan Omuka. Here we have it again. The boot from Pius Shiundu. Alan Omuka coming in very strong, sending his man down. No regard whatsoever. Now, they have to watch out for that. They have to watch out for that. If they send that ball deep, they're going to have to watch out for Omuka. He's going to come back with that massive handoff. He showed it time and time again in the Super Series. Of course, that massive hit against Rwenzori in Uganda, which went viral on YouTube and all rugby sites that we know of so far. I can only imagine how that feels for Quinto Ongo.
Well, he'll have to just keep chugging, because unless anything happens, his opponent for the day is Alan Omuka. So that's the reason he was selected by the coach. He has to stand up to the challenge.
Of course, in the words of 1 second row, former KCB, former homeboys, Polycarp Odhiambo, he said, if you don't want to get hit, don't be embarrassed, don't play the game. Everyone has experienced it one time or another. We even saw it happen against, especially even the world's best flanker, Richie Mako, has experienced it countless times being set down. So it's just part of the game.
Yeah, and surely done that massive handoff from Alan Omuka has actually ignited the crowd here that had been, to that moment, been quiet. This is Isabwa, again, just looking up and finding space.
Ongo with a chance to set his team in a better position. And he's on the chase. John Ahenda seems to interfere with that one. Lineout goes to KCB. Well, down at their own five.
Felix Wanjala and John Ahenda just failed to communicate there. Ahenda just taking his eye off the ball for a second. The on-rushing Quinto Ongo just booted it and it went out into touch. And this is in a dangerous position, although KCB will have possession for the line-out, which they retain.
Peter
but Andrew Karani penalizes the Bankers.
Bankers unable to send that one straight. Of course, their option was good to send it all the way to the sixth ball at the back of the lineout, which Impala was not expecting. But unfortunately for them, it was not sent straight. So they are penalized with a scrum down on their five. Let's see how aggressive Impala can come back into this game. This could be the determining factor to see if they have their heads in this one and are ready for it. There's the put-in. KCB defending vehemently, walking completely over the Impala scrummage. Of course, the referee calling... penalizing them there. Very good reaction from Joel Omer on that one. He takes the ball in, managing to consolidate that ball. Moses Kola trying to marshal his troops, trying to find the space.
That's Jeffrey Anampio just cutting into space. Impala keeping it alive. This is Nyandigisi. Cross kick there. Dawi Mukiza retrieves it and calls for the mark. But the referee, Andrew Karani, had spotted an earlier infringement. And the advantage remains with Impala. Quickly taken penalty. Nyandigisi spotted the try line, but had to contend with the defenders from KCB. This is a desperate moment for Impala, looking to stay in the game.
And in jersey number 24, Impala, Warren Nyanjom, unfortunately being carried off the pitch.
And so Impala unable to turn that spell of possession in a positive part of the pitch into points, and the advantage has slipped away from their fingers. It's a chance probably you feel that they will rue as the game continues to wear on.
Coming in jersey number 7 for Warren Nyanjom, for Impala's Warren Nyanjom, jersey number 7 is Felix. There we have it again. There we have it again. That massive palm, that massive handoff from Alan Omuka. This is going to be a problem for Impala if he continues this way. If they do not, if they don't manage to shut him down early on, they're going to face a long day in the office. As I was saying, in jersey number 7 coming in for Warren Nyanjom, Felix Okari. Nyanjom not looking too good at the moment. Must have taken a bit of a big hit there or fallen wrong. Those pile-up situations can be a bit messy. Here we have KCB's backline.
That's Isa Otieno.
KCB's backline seem to look very relaxed.
This is Peter Carrier just keeping it alive. Felix Wanjala doing the wise thing, knowing that he had a man on rushing, just taking it into contact. Really, Dan, at this point, you just feel the Bankers are toying around with Impala. They're bossing the contact area.
And they're definitely looking like the more conditioned team at the moment. They're showing no signs of fatigue, no knocks that have taken them down. Unfortunately for Impala, they've already gotten a few knocks, a few players are down. We have Warren Nyanjom, who is out, already making a replacement by bringing in Felix Okari. So it depends, but There we have a slight sight of two players for KCB down. Well, it's just evidence that I spoke maybe too soon. Jonah Henda icing his head very briefly. Must have taken a knock to the face. Of course, that one is something that you can understand. I don't understand how you could probably condition your face to take hits. Very vulnerable area. Line out, kick deep. Of course, not too deep. Here we have another line out for KCB.
You know, Dan, I'm still thinking about the conditioning your face comment and thinking with the innovativeness of Kenyans, somebody will probably come up with a program very soon. Don't be surprised.
Let's just hope that that it would help certain people's looks. Of course, over the years of rugby, lots of scars and bruises can mess up. And the mall looks very solid, very good. Almost too easy for KCB. Way too easy. Impala putting in absolutely no effort there.
Philip Omai, the try scorer, bemused. You could just see his face after the scoring the try. Philip Omai with the try. KCB's third try of the game.
Third try of the game. He looked almost shocked that he scored so easily.
You know, at this point of the game, you just feel that KCB is completely outmuscling Impala. I mean, they just steamrolled over them. And the interesting bit is that is how they have scored all their tries, similar fashion. I mean, they're going with what works for them. Darwin Mukidza has had a good kicking afternoon so far, 2 out of 2. Let's see if he can make it 3 out of 3.
Absolutely no resistance on the more that from Impala on that one. Darwin Mukidza this time unable to add insults to injury. So current scores for KCB. KCB 19, Impala still at 3. Just a quick observation here. The body language of the Impala forwards doesn't seem like that of the KCB bankers.
It's very different. You can feel the knocks. You can actually see the knocks. The KCB players really just out-muscling their opponents. There's really nothing much to say. It'll take a lot more from Impala if they're to stay in contention in this game. That's a good take from Edwin Otieno.
Very good take indeed. Committed himself completely to that one. Not able to send that one too far out for KCB. Still within their danger zone, but of course their forwards are the more dominant ones at the moment. I don't want to speak too soon. Excellent take right there from Jesse Ngessa. Very aware. Caught KCB sleeping with their pants down completely. And Impala seem to have found a second wind with this one. Unfortunately, they lose the ball in contact. And let's see if they can bring back that second wind. Issa Otieno running it down to the other end of the pitch and kicking it deep. Nyandikisi managed to take that one.
This is Joel Omer attempting to take it into contact, which he does, retaining possession for Impala. Moses Kola just looking to marshal his troops there. Sami Oliech has Duncan Ekasi and Jeffrey Anampiu for company. We have Robert Aringo out wide. Robert Aringo against Darwin Mukidza.
Robert Aringo very, very strong in the contact area. It looked very easy for him to take that ball in. And retain it. Ball has come out.
This is a good spell of possession for Impala.
A very good spell of possession from Impala. Let's hope that here we have Edgar Obino taking his man on head on. absolutely no regard for the defensive man. Of course, we have hands in the ruck. No, actually, he wasn't. He hadn't released. He had his hands on the ball before the ruck situation was formed. Edgar Obino having trouble getting up after that hit. And I think this is becoming almost too characteristic for the Impala players, taking a while to get up after every hit.
And let's just look at it again. There he is going into contact. You just, we really can't tell what happened. Would probably need the insight of another camera, but doesn't look too good. Remember, John Ahenda, the KCB second row, is also a medical doctor, and he was on the scene there just ensuring that his opponent gets treatment, gets first aid. Remember, in rugby, you always put safety first.
Of course, no matter how aggressive the game may be, sportsmanship is not something to be compromised. Coming on for Edgar Obino, we have Matthew Musali in jersey number 16, looking much, much bigger than the last time I saw him. Has proved to be an Impala diehard. Had a short stint at the Mean Machine, University of Nairobi's Mean Machine. Made his way back to Impala RFC, Resolution Impala Saracens, after completing his studies.
Peter Carrier with the line out throw there for KCB. Ahenda just taking it into contact and running into another veteran, Moses Kola. This is Felix Wanjala. He has Curtis Lilako, the two try hero, out wide. Lilako, knowing that he doesn't have the pace, that was Moses Amsala, I beg your pardon, just keeping it tight for the bankers. This is Edwin Otieno. Wanjala again, he's at the heart of things for the bankers. This is Michael Omondi, the man they call a zebra. Don't ask me why.
And there we have Issa Otieno managing to offload the ball perfectly, but they fumbled it just at the last minute. Looked like some very good interplay there in the back line of KCB. And here we have it again. As it goes wide, here we have Issa Otieno on that massive, that excellent break. Offloading it. Excellent offload, just wasn't caught. I must say that was an excellent offload. He didn't even turn his waist the other direction, didn't force it. Almost came naturally. Again, another danger zone for the Impala Saracens. Just inside their 22, KCB bankers have just won that one. Let's see if they're going to see the gap or take it out wide. He's taking it out wide. Unable to consolidate that one, and it's gone into touch. This game seems almost too easy for the bankers.
Yeah, it's almost like a training session. You just feel there's little, if no, resistance from Impala. They simply have not come out for the first half of this match. The body language really not giving much in terms of positivity. It'll take a whole huge effort from the Impala Saracens to come back into this game and win this game. At the moment, KCB are the ones who are coasting. Felix Wanjala just retrieving the ball into John Ahenda. Ahenda again just attacking the space and setting up another platform for the bankers.
With 3 minutes left in, 2 minutes left in this first half, I'd like to know how many meters John Ahenda has run already, because he's definitely one of the key ball carriers. He loves to carry the ball. Very good on defense, but hasn't had the chance to defend much since KCB have had most of the possession. Here we have KCB just outside the five.
This is Peter Waitere again, just taking it in. You just feel that the can do this all day and not get any resistance from Impala. That's just how things are turning out here.
Felix Wanjala looking for where to take the ball, but John Ahenda snaps it up just out of his hands. He didn't even see that coming.
John Ahenda playing like a roving flanker, and he's playing from the back row. This is Issa Otieno. Remember, the referee Andrew Karani had played advantage there.
Issa Otieno taking that hit very well, definitely the more conditioned player. Unfortunately, that was one of Impala's locks.
This is Billy Sabwa just chipping it over the Impala back line.
Very concerning that Eric Opondo would get up so slowly after a knock from such a small man.
I choose not to comment further on that. I choose to comment rather on the tactical aspects, because I remember back in the day during the training sessions, you were always told to get up quickly from the tackle, because when you're on the ground, you actually deplete the numbers on your team. It's as if your team is playing one man less.
Exactly. But I just had to express my concern on that one. Of course, there must be a different conditioning program that every team is using within this. Depends on your preparation. And there we have it, the halftime scores. KCB 19, Resolution Impala Saracens 3.
That's impressive.
They ready?
I think it's ready.
Boom Jaka, hype man number one.
Why? You make him lose his focus. Oh no, sorry.
All right, check this out.
We shall invigorate our fire.
That right there is impossible.
Excuse me?
Video is what having the time of our lives.
Hey, are you ready, Patrick?
You bet.
And it was all going so well, and then this happened.
Come on!
Join us.
These are moments that I treasure.
Gets in there. What an effort! What a goal!
Jesus said, "Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest."
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Match Day 5 of the Kenya Cup right here at the RFUEA Grounds on the 12th of December. Aiding me in this slight commentary as we go over the highlights is Biko Adema.
Yeah,
welcome
Dan.
Back, Biko.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's been an interesting game. And like I said, the power, the raw power of the KCB team has been shown here. We see guys like Alan Omuka, man, having a field day against these Impala players, almost giving everyone on the pitch a handoff, man, you know, and even Darwin, you know, having some great runs as well. So, like I said, it's been tough for Impala. Just there you've seen Omuka.
Absolutely. And just a quick take on what you think of the Impala Saracens forwards right now. What do you think is going on? What do you think that they could be talking about at this particular point in time? Showing the lack of aggression, the lack of trying to defend that second more. Actually, it was the third more. The try scored by Darwin. Not by Darwin Mukidza. Of course, that by Philip Wamai, of course, the captain. When he seems to find it way too easy.
Yes. The Impala forwards, I think they're just trying to get that confidence at the moment. They're trying to man up against these big KCB forwards. You can see even the likes of Ahenda and Amusala and also Lilako, as I mentioned in the beginning. These guys are running at these forwards. They're running at the backs of Impala. So they're giving them a really hard time. And it's going to be interesting to see whether the Impala players, both forwards and backs, can pick themselves up during this halftime and, you know, prove something.
Of course, there's 40 minutes left in the game with 19-3 to go. KCB are leading, looking very dismal for Impala at the moment if they maintain that kind of pace. They did have a slight burst of hope at about the 25th or 26th minute of the game when they found themselves heading as close as the KCB's 5-yard. That was a very good burst of energy from them, especially in the forwards. It was the good interplay that came in between Jesse Ngessa and Edgar Obino, that short line out that came in. And unfortunately, they lost Edgar Obino to an injury. They've brought in Matthew Musalia. I think he's going to be some really very good impact for Impala. He's an impact player. That's why he's on the bench, not because he's not good enough.
Yes, as you mentioned earlier, I mean, Musalia is a very, I think he's a very skillful player. He's a very skillful forward, and he should bring in some burst of energy. You said he had added some weight. He has added some weight, actually. And he looks pretty fit, actually. And but the notable player for me in Impala at the moment is Warren Nyanjom. I mean, he's really putting his body on the line. He's carrying the ball really well. I mean, he's showing a lot of potential, man. And that's a real player to watch out for in this game. And I hope that he can bring out the best of his teammates in the next half, you know.
Unfortunately for him, we're yet to know if he's going to be able to resurface on the pitch. He suffered a slight injury down at KCB's 5-yard. Felix Okari is his replacement at open side flanker. Felix Okari, also former Kenya under 19, very strong, very conditioned, has undergone some of the regimes of the under 19 side, which I would say, if you've gone through, you know what it's like to be
And I think, like you said, I mean, the current crop that are coming from the under 19, man, these guys are looking really strong, really powerful. They're looking really confident. You know, the likes of Nyanjom, Okari, even in the KCB side, we have Billy Isabwa, man, looking very good. He's distributing the ball to his backs very well. So, I mean, the new crop of players are looking very confident and very, very explosive.
Absolutely, they are. And Anthony Nyandigisi looking very comfortable at number 10 for Impala. Hasn't run into any intense problems just yet. Seems to be very comfortable. If the Impala forwards, I think, can set the platform stable enough to be able to give him enough space to do what he needs to do with his backline, I do think that he'll be able to maximize on his centers and wingers in a game like this.
Yes, Nyandigisi, I mean, he always looks very calm, man. You know, he's one of those guys who's below emotions, man, you know. And he doesn't really show any fear during a game, whether it's going good or bad. But I think if you say, if we can just get his forwards going and distribute a bit more to his outside backs, then we can get a good game going for us and a very entertaining game.
Well, it looks like the KCB are done with their team talk. They seem to be coming back onto the pitch. I do believe that KCB's bench is looking much stronger. Those are just... what's the right terminology to use? It looks like they're just animals in a cage ready to be let loose.
We've got
some of the most unlikely players who we did not spot last season, especially Eli Mukaisi for KCB at the open side flank. He's a very, very, very key impact player. But also, let's not forget people like Kelvin Skarani for Impala, or Joshua Momanyi, Tyson Okoth. These are guys who can come back into the game and set a standard.
And Dan, you also forgot to mention the likes of Fabian Orlando is also on the bench for KCB. And, you know, he's a very explosive, fast player. So it would be exciting to see him on the pitch.
Absolutely. And you know what it's like to play with and against Fabian Orlando on an international level.
Yes, I do.
So I'll definitely take your word for that one. I've experienced him not from the same team side, but on the receiving end of one of his powerful runs. And as we go back into the second half, the kickoff, KCB in the green going down to your right. Impala Saracens, Resolution Impala Saracens in the white and red coming back across the pitch to your left. Okay, thank you very much, Biko, as we welcome back Michael Kwambo.
Bilem! Bilem! Bilem!
First scrummage of the game, of actually of the second half, pardon me, I need to correct myself on that one. First scrummage of the second half, KCB already managing to force Resolution Impala Saracens into an error. Moses Kola doing very well to keep himself onside there. Impala Saracens managing to set that tackle very solidly, not budging. Here we have Joel Omer almost trying to just barely disrupt that one. John Ahenda going straight through the defense, unable to get that offload.
Scrum, white ball.
We have another knock on. And I think this is where KCB bankers are going to have a field day, more or less, on the scrummage, the forwards. This is where they are setting their platform.
Probably, although let's also see what Impala have to do in the second half. Remember, on their technical bench, you also have Frankie Ndong, former Kenya international prop, and of course, one who is well versed in the matters of scrummaging.
And he must have some tricks up his sleeve. He must have said something right, because Impala have come out of that scrum perfectly. Of course, unfortunately, the pass to Anthony Nyandigisi didn't go as planned, and he's managed to just barely recover from that one by booting the ball out, sending it away. That was a very high-pressure situation after such a Herculean effort in the second half by Impala Saracens forwards.
Money mark, boys.
And Peter Carrier preparing to take the line-out throw for KCB. Peter Carrier, a former Kenya under-19 international.
Give me 10, just push back.
An outstanding run during the Bamburi Rugby Super Series and also the Impala Floodlit. He's establishing himself as a key member of the KCB side. This is Isao Otieno, who just kicks away possession to Robert Aringo.
And of course, Impala's backline's line speed, I will continue to say their line speed of the defense is perfect. Quinton Ongo managed to just get up and cut off the overlap. As we do know, if a winger rushes that overlap just in time, he will cut it off just right. And he managed to do that, resulting in Impala's possession of the ball currently, which is looking very good. They seem to have a second wind in them. Something was said right. They have realized that they do need to fight harder for this one. Moses Kola just snapping that loose ball up as it rolled out of the ruck. Not looking too bad for Impala Saracens in this second half. And a quick box kick right into space, forcing the KCB bankers to turn.
Come back, green. Just getting them out of the 22-meter area. There's a lot of ball watching, which is rather peculiar. 3 minutes into the second half, you'd still expect people to have a lot of gas. That's something you'd see closer towards the end of the match.
Absolutely. Pius Yundo, of course, seems to have that gas. He's showing a lot of determination in his runs. Unfortunately, on that one, he wasn't able to get too far. The forwards seem like they want to take this one. Moses Kola dishing it out to Bobby Quare, who goes in very strong, just managing to go down with that one, retain possession, shipping it out again. Anthony Nyandigisi taking it to Edgar Obino, who seems to be held up. Here come in the other forwards trying to drive him over. KCB not putting much effort into holding their man up. And there we have it.
Just using the physicality there to turn over possession.
And KCB not looking like they're even breaking a sweat.
No, we talked about that in the first half. And it's going to take a lot from Impala. It's going to be a Herculean effort for them.
Scrum.
But I'm liking the attitude that they've come back into the second half with, looking much more urgent, not as lethargic as they were. It seems like they just needed a slight wake-up call. Let's hope for the best for them, because they do have an outstanding back row at the moment. Joel Omer, Felix Okari, and Duncan Akasi. We haven't seen too much of them other than Joel Omer. Let's wait and see if they can manage to pull something out of the hat on this one.
And as we speak, KCB just making their first substitution. Out goes Isao Otieno. In his place comes Fabian Orlando, making his first Kenya Cup appearance of the season. Remember, he got injured during the season opening Gold Coast Sevens in Australia in October this year. He's been out for quite a while, making his first league appearance of the season. And with it has come a tactical change. Darwin Mukiza slots into fullback. Fabian Orlando heads to the wing. This is Moses Amsala. Was in two minds there as to whether to out the ball or just taking it in. This is Mukiza.
Kids are running very well, managing to get the offload all the way to Fabian Orlando.
This is continuity.
Back to Mukiza.
This is Billy Sabwa.
Excellent dummy there. Just scooping it back up. KCB looking very good on the drive when they have the ball in contact. Just a quick observation for KCB. I think is you would know this better. Is Peter Waitera one of the smallest eighth men that KCB have ever had? I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with a slightly smaller eighth man, but I've always known KCB's eighth man to be absolutely massive.
You know, looking through the history books, he probably is.
But he's doing just as good a job as any of the others have done in history.
Went forward.
Which is a very good look for him.
Scrum.
And as I said earlier, Kelvin's current coming onto the pitch. Kelvin's Karani for Resolution Impala Saracens coming in for Jesse Ingesa. Looking very beat, looking very exhausted. Jesse Ingesa has done his best so far. On the sideline, speaking to Frank Ndong, is Matthew Musalia.
Remember, Matthew Musalia was part of the Kenyan squad that played at the JWRT when it was hosted in Nairobi in the year 2009. At that time, he was just getting out of high school, played his first season at Impala, went off to Mean Machine, where he studied his tertiary education and has returned to the club that gave him a launchpad in club rugby. It's going to be an Impala putting from the scrum down.
Moses Impala Kola looking much better on the scrum down. Excellent take from them there, managing to walk it a little bit. There we have Duncan Akasi picking it up, running wide right into the centers. Unfortunately, losing it.
It was actually Moses Kola.
Sorry, that was Moses Kola. Unfortunately, he lost that one. Unable to retain the ball in contact. Very unfortunate for them, but they still get the ball. The infringement was
it's a huge boot into touch.
And here we have Kelvin's Karani. Kelvin's Karani waiting for to take to throw his first line out since he came in. Wanting to send it not so deep. Excellent take there by Impala. The good shuffle. Anthony Nyandigisi. Of course, it's an advantage for him that he plays at center, that he would be playing fly half. Unfortunate for Karani. That one went straight into the hands.
This is Brian Sagara, but he's gone all alone. He has numbers now arriving to support him. Felix Wanjala.
And there we have Felix Okari, who just managed to get his hands on that box kick by Wanjala. Very good awareness there.
There was Sagara just breaking on his own. And we just look at Wanjala. He really didn't attempt to even raise the ball over his opponent. You just feel maybe he was aware of the referee's call at that point in time.
Of course, after years of experience in the game, you do realize that there is a point in time where you do manage to just force the penalty on the opposing team, as opposed to instead just play it. Because sometimes it is easier to just force the penalty, get the distance that you need, as opposed to fight and look for the space that could not be there.
So it's going to be KCB's throwing for the line-out.
Peter Carrier. Will be made by Brian Sagara. They shuffle it all the way to the sixth ball, taking it in for a more. Looking a little more aggressive on defending this more. They've managed to disrupt it. A very good look from the forwards. They seem to have woken up in the second half of this game. Can they maintain it? Can they catch up? Will they be able to score the points they need to stay in this game? John Ahenda unable to gain ground there, losing the gain line.
This is Brian Omondi, receives that ball at pace from Felix Wanjala.
Very good tackle made by Anthony Nyandigisi there. Very good line speed from Impala. It's looking much more organized, a little more determination. Kelvin's Karani unable to make the tackle there.
Once
Omuka
again,
just getting
Omuka,
away.
He's been a thorn in the flesh of Impala.
Absolutely.
This is Curtis Lilako. That was a huge charge from Lilako as he gains ground for the bankers.
And he's just able to go to ground despite them trying to hold him up.
This is Brian Omondi looking to attack the space, but meeting the attentions of Jeffrey Anampio. But it's still KCB in possession in a very promising part of the pitch. Philip Wamae.
Such an unfortunate situation. They could have gone into the bonus point on that one.
And this is Fabian Orlando versus Pierce Shiundu. Fabian Orlando.
The foot race is on. He's just managed to get away from one. Can he go through the others? Is he going to kick it or will he take it in? He took it in to Robert Quare.
This is Billy Sabwa.
Tackle! Rakas formed! Step, 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 step!
This is John Ahenda picking up the loose ball. He has Moses Kola. Curtis Lilako just playing it to Eric Kopondo.
Come back wide!
Eric Kopondo boots it.
Onside.
But only as far as Brian Omondi, who has Eric Kopondo to deal with. That's a crunching tackle from Eric Kopondo, redeeming himself after throwing away possession. You just feel the game is beginning to turn on its end, but you just feel also tempers are slightly beginning to fray. They may not immediately flare up now, but you just feel there's an element of emotion checking into this game.
Sit down.
And maybe that's just what Impala needed. There we have Eric Kopondo. Just making that tackle after booting the ball. Very good look from him. Very good commitment, realizing that that was not his place to kick. Although I think he did the right thing, cleared it out of the danger zone.
9-12 white out. 9-12 white.
Coming onto the pitch right now, I've just spotted...
So it's Jeffrey Anampiu and Moses Kola who are making way. Kola is probably going to be replaced by Michael Mugo at scrum half. Still yet to confirm who is going to replace Anampiu at center.
Probably looks like they've pushed up the centers.
I can see Ian Minjiri on the pitch.
We have Ian Minjiri on the wing. So they've managed to push up the centers.
Sanyo Let looks as if he has slotted into the center position vacated by Jeffrey Anampiu.
Time, mate.
But KCB remain in possession on the attack. It's been a much closely contested second half until I spoke.
When they just managed to pull that one back, KCB, Felix Wanjala with the drop kick. There we have on the screen Eli Mukaisi just warming up. And here we are, second half of this game. KCB at 21. KCB at 22, sorry. Resolution Impala Saracens still at 3. That was actually a result of a drop kick from Felix Wanjala. Very good spotting of the space there. He put himself in not a potentially shallow pocket. It was actually a very shallow pocket. And he could have just missed that one, but he went for it anyway. He knew what he was going to do. And he managed to consolidate those points as necessary.
Because if you're on the tackle, they're just lying flat on the ball. They're not making an effort.
Okay.
That's why you're finding them.
Resolution Impala Saracens unable to come back so far, thus far in the game. but a lot more commitment needed. Who knows? Maybe they did need that little burst of emotion to get them going.
You have about 28 minutes.
For those of you who don't know, that the veteran Moses Kola, this is his second start of the season for Impala, starting at scrum half. Anthony Nyandigisi, who featured in the all-season outside center, starts at fly half. Started at fly half, is still at fly half in the continued absence of Nato Simiu. Robert Odhiando and Quinton Ongo for the Resolution Impala Saracens, of course, took the pitch at the start of the game for Kanyeri Kariuki and Ian Minjiria, who has just come onto the pitch in the back line. A slightly tweak there in the back line. But as the game progresses, we seem to see that we have Michael Mugo, who came onto the pitch. We're getting to Joel Omer, who sees the space very strong in the run, very stout. The ruck seems very solid. Ball going out wide all the way to Samuel Yech, who takes the ball in. Very good cover of the ruck.
And this is a good face of play for Impala. You just see them playing with their tails up.
And finally, some characteristic play from Impala Saracens.
That's Kelvin's Munene there, just managing to take it into contact, keep it alive. This is a good face. We have Duncan Ekasi out wide against Fabian Orlando, taking it into contact and losing possession. Philip Wamai now turning over possession for KCB.
Duncan Ekasi did actually have Ian Minjiria there for him on the wing. All he needed to do was to pop it quickly to Minjiria. And there we have the turnover. Not good. The ruck situation was formed there. A little bit of slightly unsportsmanly play. That was very unsportsmanlike from Joel Omer. Completely unnecessary.
Well, these are the points of the game where you just need to keep yourself in check. Avoid those unnecessary distractions.
Unless it's feet too long, huh?
You know, just focus on the match. I mean, that is totally uncalled for use of energy. Should have been channeled elsewhere. Billy Sabwa looking to boot the ball into touch. That was a massive penalty from Billy Isabwa. Finding touch deep in Impala territory. And we know what the bankers have done from this time and again in this match.
Let's see if the Impala Saracens forwards can put something back on this one, can put some resistance on the mall if KCB go for this one. They're slightly further out than they were on the previous three. Let's see if they will go for it this time or decide to push it out to the back line. Just looking at the numbers, it looks like they're all in. So it possibly could be what we think it's going to be.
So the substitutions made by KCB, out goes Peter Waitere and Edwin Otieno. In their places come
Eli Mukaisi there in jersey number. Sun is beating that one rather hard.
But just can't quickly looking at jersey number 19, and jersey number 18 is Stafford Abeka. So they made a change at the back row, probably just looking to have a lot more impetus as they wind up this match. But they'll not have it with advantage swinging Impala's way.
Duncan Ekasi on the overthrow on that one, taking it straight to ground and able to actually run it. And we take it out.
Advantage is over.
Just managing to kick it into slight space, giving the ball a bit of a bounce, and his men able time to run. But here we have Darwin Mukidza to Philip Wamai, slashing through the Impala Saracens defense. Felix Wanjala to Curtis Lilako, who takes it in strong, beating the gain line just barely. Let's wait and see what happens here. Taking it out to Peter Karia, who's caught just behind the gain line. Can they react to this one as needed? Eric Opondo just managing to get a hand on that one as he tried to get back onside.
They're moving forward, scrum.
And unfortunately for Impala Saracens, the ball goes KCB's way.
So it's going to be a KCB put in from the scrum down. Very close to the Impala try line. It's going to take a Herculean effort from Impala. Let's see what they're made of at this point in time.
Current scores, ladies and gentlemen, in match day 5, KCB versus Impala. KCB currently at 22 to a Resolution. Impala Saracens at 3 points.
And remember, if you're joining us, we have played 19 minutes of the second half. As Dan has said, KCB leading Impala 22 points for 3-3. KCB's points have come from tries that have been scored by Curtis Lilako, who touched down twice. Philip Omai, who touched down once. Darwin Mukiza added two conversions, and Felix Wanjala scored a drop goal. Impala's solitary points thus far have come from the veteran Moses Kola, who scored a penalty midway through the first half. 22-3 the scores here at the RFUEA Grounds.
19.
Massive boot putting Impala all the way back down past KCB, KCB's half. Matthew Msala getting ready to throw this line out. Very good look for them. They managed to retain that one. Ball going out to the center of the field, down to the wing. They've taken it wide instantly. Good chip, but just into the hands.
That was Darwin Mukiza, who just called for the mark. Just relieving the pressure from his side.
And completely killing the momentum, any momentum whatsoever that Impala were trying to build up on. They send it back. They send it back down. Nyandigisi looking to boot this one, looking very relaxed.
Which he does. Another substitution for Impala. Out goes Eric Kofondo, and in comes Kenya under 19 international Tyson Okoth. So it's going to be KCB throwing at this line out. Peter Carrier just preparing himself once again.
Just take a step.
Peter Carrier just trying to dry off the ball there with his jersey.
And you know, had this been another code of football, the one that they play with a round ball, Peter Carrier would probably have been called for wasting time. But that's not the case. He was genuinely just cleaning the ball. KCB retaining possession from the line out.
Taking it wide, sending it back in to Fabian Orlando, who loses it in contact. Impala managing to keep this one. They have an overlap. Can they utilize it?
One block.
Ian Minjire, his first touch on the ball. Fighting very hard on that one, taking it to ground. Good line speed coming in from Eli Mukaisi. Forced a turnover for the KCB bankers.
No advantage, lost forward.
No, Eli Mukaisi reminds me of the late Anthony Ochino in the way he plays, and I'm sure you played against him.
I had the privilege of one or two games. And Eli Mukaisi is not necessarily the biggest, but he has put on a lot of weight, quite a considerable amount of weight since the Super Series. He's stood out since then and only been on the up and up, and it's good to see him progressing, especially with a team such as the KCB Bankers, and mainly solidifying his spot, not only at the line-out as a jumper, but also in the tackle, on defensive situations, in the breakdown, very disruptive. And this is a good look for KCB, being able to snap up such players before they're picked by anyone else.
Meanwhile, as we speak, Quinto Ongo just being assisted off the pitch by physiotherapist Chris Makacha. George Okoa looks to be the man who's going to slot in his place. Yes, it is George Okoa who comes in for Quinto Ongo. Quinto not looking too good. Probably looks like a thigh. No, he's clutching the back of his thigh, so probably looks like a hamstring injury. Would we say he's hamstrung?
Looks more like an ankle injury. Could be actually the entire leg may have just pulled. But actually, from where I can see, it does look like his ankle. Here we have Philip Wamai running the ball a good 10 yards before getting taken down. Very big tackle there. Very good, solid tackle by Tyson Okoth.
KCB and here we have a man KCB, out wide.
Unfortunately, unable to pass that one to get that ball to hand. And the foot race is on. Samuel Lietch, unfortunately, tripping up behind Darwin Mukidza on that chase. Line out again for Impala. They're throwing, taking it all the way down, shuffling, coming back up. Robert Aringo on that one, popping it to Duncan Ekasi. And just losing hold of it in contact.
Just as Impala seemed to be gaining ground, attacking KCB. Remember, Impala yet to score a try in this match. Malim Kolwe is on for Felix Wanjala at scrum half for KCB. Michael Mugo just pressing him. This is Benjamin Ojema, who has come in for Billy Isabwa. Ian Mijire fielding that ball, stepping, but not escaping the attentions of Stafford Abeka. Eli Mugaisi now and Pius Shiwundu.
Going at it, former teammates, UAP Kifaru Bamburi Rugby Super Series champions. Ian Minjiri with an excellent dummy there, running it down.
Get off.
This is Eric Carey just stepping and attacking the space. Duncan Ekasi doing well to keep possession this time on the tackle. The advantage remains with Impala. Nyandikisi with the quickly taken penalty. This is
Robert Arrigo. Felix Okari, things not looking too good for him after that scrummage. Seems to have caught a finger in the eye.
Hands off!
A rock situation was formed.
Mark is here.
Fabian Orlando was not authorized to put his hands in that ruck. And two players down for Impala, Felix Okari and Robert Aringo, who seems to be having trouble getting up, but he's on his feet. Robert Quare doing very well to keep that one in play. Ball going to Impala.
This is scrum. Captain.
Quite a bit of concern right now by the medics for Felix Okari.
That's the last one. Yeah.
Things not looking too good for him. Came out of that scrum down and went down. Clutching at his face. More or less his eyes. We don't know what this could be a case of. It wasn't clear. As the referee goes to check, to see what's going on with Felix Okari. And from KCB's last game, I think it's important to note that Darwin Mukidza was the only change that they made in the back line. Of course, he's starting at the wing ahead of Peter Kilonzo. Felix Okari coming off the pitch. Very unfortunate for him. Coming onto the pitch is Joshua Momanyi in jersey number 18. Very good to see him back after so long. Coming into second row. Going to push Okoth out to flank.
And let's just see if that makes the Impala forwards a lot more compact and a lot more competitive. Because Joshua is indeed a big man, and he probably gives them that necessary weight at second row. This is George Okoa.
Yenemi Njire managing to fight off one man, getting taken down by the second.
Matthew Musalia
fighting his way.
Tackle!
Just managed to go to ground. KCB are in the habit of holding their men up.
That's Eric Carey. This is a good spell once again for Impala. Looking to cross the KCB try line. A wayward pass from Nyandi Gisi.
Putting Robert Aringo in a spot of bother. Completely setting up his man. Horrible, in a horrible situation. But Impala managed to retain the ball.
Counter-attack is good. Counter-attack is good.
This is John Ahenda. Just cleaning it up for the bankers. Mukolo with the box kick.
Didn't manage to get it too far out. Ian Minjire, excellent player, especially on the high ball. Very strong in the tackle. And that pass was somewhat forward, being caught by John Ahenda. As again, I'd say, I'd like to know how many yards he's run in this game so far.
I think for me, he's been the workhorse for the bankers. You know, just turning back the years, giving the performances that we knew him for many years ago. You know, just he's coming been back everywhere, and he's been playing at secondary. You'd think he's a roving flanker.
Absolutely, and considering that he's come back off an injury, and he's managed to maintain his form, it's a very good look for him. Darwin Mukidza sending that one all the way down the pitch.
And then also to think that Ahenda is the oldest man on the KCB lineup, 32 years of age, still going strong.
Throw in coming in for KCB, just after the halfway line. Again, with the shuffle, not too much. Philip Omai taking it, and they go in for the more. Duncan Ekasi coming in, managing to penetrate through. Of course, there's no offense in that one. He went through. He found the little spaces, the little errors that KCB made in that one.
This is Brian Omondi losing the ball when he took it into contact.
Characteristic there of Robert Aringo on the turnover. You sleep, you snooze, you lose. Ian Minjire with a quick offload. Here we have Pius Shiundu. Can he take it down the line? He's unable to find the offload and taken into touch. Not enough men there to support him just when he needed it.
Shiundu just marshaled into touch there by Stafford Abeka and Brian Sagara.
But of course, there was a very good effort from him there. Very good commitment shown. Just an unfortunate situation.
Align your players, 17. Open the gap, white. Open the gap. Close the gap, move in.
Bankers making changes once again.
Moses Amsala and Alan Omuka are off. Collins Wanjala coming on. Alongside his brother, who's a prop, Oscar Simiu. Both of them have been Kenya under-19 internationals in subsequent years. Collins Wanjala playing on the 2012 Kenya under-19 squad. Oscar Simiu playing in the 2013 and 2014 squads. And there he is.
Oscar Serrano, very good run, very solid. And very big step.
From George Asin, a front row stepping.
Front row stepping.
He'd make Hilary Teller proud.
Very proud. Just goes to show that the front row is evolving in the game. The front row is definitely evolving in the game. They step more. They have better ball skills. No longer just what we were first made to believe they are.
Legend has it that George Asin was once a fly half. Meanwhile, this is Samuel Lietch. Searching
all the way
run.
Down the line.
Just tapped into touch by Mukidza. But that was awesome stuff from Samuel Lietch. Proving to
excellent
be the attacking
from
threat
Samuel
that
he attacked that one with nothing but class. Unfortunately, he was unable to keep his feet.
They'll just look at the KCB subs. You just feel they have used their entire complement of substitutes. I'll just confirm.
They have used the entire complement of substitutes, making sure that everyone gets a taste of this game. 72 minutes in, not long to go. Current scores, KCB 22, Resolution Impala Saracens at 3. Are they able to score any more at this point? Then we have on our screen the coaching, the management, the coaching staff of KCB.
Looking Curtis Olago and Dennis Mwanja.
Dennis Mwanja, of course, former Kenya Sevens Ironman. And of course, I hear that he is not playing. I spoke to him a few days ago, and he told me that he has chosen not to play out of choice, not out of necessity. He wants to give the younger players more of a chance to develop their skills. He seems to have be very content with what he's done in the game so far, and a very noble thing to do. Unfortunate there for Impala with a knock on. KCB scooping that one up. They're able to play it on advantage.
That's Michael Mundi.
Finding
just chipping
space.
It out. This is Shiundu under pressure from Collins Wanjala.
The ball just going into touch for the KCB bankers.
Excuse me, just leave the ball down. You don't have to be holding it.
So George Asin to take the line out throw for KCB. Looked a bit dodgy and eventually going Impala's way.
Michael Mugu swinging it out wide to Duncan Nikasi and Felix Okos.
That's Nyandigisi. Good. Playing it to George Okoa.
Putting it he in has excellent Samuel space. Samuel Lech, once again, can he take it down at the line?
But once
just
again,
being
just
dragged
into
touch.
Seems these KCB guys have done their research on Samuel Lech, not allowing him any inch of space.
But we have seen in previous games, and we do know from history, that once you give Samuel Lech the inkling of an idea of space, he will be completely gone, and you will not see him. The next time you see him is coming back from the try line after scoring with a massive grin on his face.
We have about 5 minutes to play. The scores remain KCB 22, Resolution Impala Saracens 3. Remember, the next match after this will be a match between the hosts Kenya Harlequin and Total Nondies. That match kicks off at 4 p.m. East Africa time.
Crouch! Mind!
And remember, we also have in our company Biko Adema, who's going to be helping us out with analysis at the end of this match. Biko, just hoping that you're still awake.
Robert Aringo taking that ball, and Impala coming in to clear that ball very well on the rock. Again, Eli Mukaisi leaving nothing to question. Running every ball down, every loose ball, anyone who is caught sleeping, he will take down. An excellent flanker, quick off the mark, very aggressive.
Well, Dan, you know, just looking at the match, especially the past 10 minutes, you just feel that the concentration levels on both sides beginning to dip. You just feel KCB know that they have an unassailable lead. They've just taken their foot off the gas pedal. Impala really clutching at straws, if you ask me.
That's exactly the situation, and I'd also like to just bring to attention that maybe KCB don't feel like they're being challenged enough to keep their minds completely engaged in the game. They are a very physical side. They are no good take from Pius Shudu, managing to get away from a few players there, but not looking too good for him on the take there.
Lopon, no advantage. That's a moment.
Yes, I did see something there. I did see something there.
Hands off!
Michael Mugu looking to take a penalty. Just looking to keep Impala in the game.
Tanaba is good.
Let's see if Impala can pull something back just for the sake of their pride. In the dying minutes of this game, 77 minutes gone. Only 3 minutes left to play. Can they work the overlap on this one?
Play on!
Just unable to. just enable to, you can hear the Impala crowd on the edge of their seats.
Holding on. Let go, let go, let me down. Advantage. Hands off!
Impala on the onslaught now. Can they get past KCB's defense?
Captain! Look, the offense was not with you. There was no advantage.
3 minutes to play.
Quite a number of penalties in the
Impala still in pursuit of their first try in this match.
The next penalty is going off.
Well, it looks like I'm going to have to say something that I didn't expect to say from last weekend. KCB, two easy games in a row. I did not want to say that, being as that Impala are formidable, but are not looking as intense as they have been looking. And again, a yellow card for Fabian Orlando.
And once again, just goes back to what we're talking about concentration, about discipline, dipping as the match wears on.
Absolutely. And this is where it counts the most. In such crucial situations is where you're able to know, will your team be able to handle the crunch time when a game is very close? Fortunately for KCB, it is not as close as it could have been.
Hold up! Scrum!
Just unable to score that one. Resolution in Palace Saracens. Not looking too good for them. With 2 minutes to go in the game, KCB, slight lapse in concentration at the moment. Again, there is the factor of them being completely engaged in the game. And of course, here at the five, of course, you can see the effect of those two big locks in the final scrimmage.
Yeah, Jesse Mamani and Eric Carey. This is Robert Aringo.
Hands off! Hands off!
Zimbabwe just looking to keep it.
Counter attack is good. Counter attack is good. Plan.
That's Matthew Musalia.
We just managed to scoop it up before the KCB players got to it on the breakdown.
Hands off! It was Jesse Momani. Just his main impact since coming on. You could actually feel the difference in the Impala forwards. Robert Aringo stepping, sniffing the timeline.
Seeing the gap just where he needed to.
And then the advantage swings back to the bankers.
Last play.
Coming just into the side.
Very frustrating for Impala. This could possibly be the last scrum down of the game, ladies and gentlemen, here on match day five. This could be the last play of match day five of Kenya Cup right here at the RFUEA Grounds. Taking the pitch next, as we can see them warming up on both ends of the pitch, are Total Nondies and the Lunch Bar Queens. There we have it. Final scores of this game. KCB 22, Resolution Impala Saracens 3.
And the result done means that KCB will go top of the table, albeit for 24 hours until tomorrow, when the rest of the leading pack plays. Nakuru and Strathmore are all in action tomorrow. But as it stands, heading into midnight tonight, KCB will lead. They have now 23 points, 5 wins from 5 games. The rest of the mathematics we shall do after the game.
Very eventful weekend right here at the RFUEA Grounds. And coming in for analysis, I'm going to invite Biko Adema once again.
Yeah.
Hapa.
The biggest headlines from around the globe. Zuku Sports News brings you all the latest from the world of sport. Tune in every morning for your daily roundup. All the action, reaction, analysis, and interviews. Zuku Sports News keeps you in the game. Zuku Sports News, your sports news today.
Wild Spirits brings you closer to the most extreme alternative and adrenaline sports from around the world. Wild Spirits, Tuesdays on Zuku Sports.
Joining me on the pitch, ladies and gentlemen, is Curtis Olago, coach of KCB, and this is after match day 5. Congratulations once again, coach, on your big win. I just wanted to ask a few questions. What do you think KCB has to offer going in towards the rest of the season and as we break for the holidays?
For the rest of the season, I can't really talk about it. We really take a game at a time. What I can talk about is the Impala game and what we expected and what we didn't expect. Remember the last two seasons we've been losing to Impala in the league. And I mean, we didn't get the bonus point because Impala is also not a pushover. You didn't get the bonus point, but we're happy. We've picked it up a notch higher from the previous two seasons, and we're happy about that. We can take 4 points and say thanks.
All right. Yeah. And what do you plan on from this match going forth? Of course, you've said that you're going to plan for one game at a time.
Yeah.
What are your expectations in the next match from your players and not from the opposition?
We're playing Western Bulls. We just have to step the training a notch higher as we go for the holidays, and we want to finish on a high.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, and once again, congratulations.
Yes.
Joining me next will be Captain Philip Wamai of KCB. And if you could just join me right now. Once again, congratulations, Philip, on your win. What do you have to say about the game and what just transpired? Did you expect more from Impala, considering the history that you guys have had in the past? Or is this something that you had seen coming?
I believe them coming from a loss last week, I knew the game was going to be tough. So I just told the boys to capitalize and defend in their line for that. And I believe that was what worked for us. We were aiming for a bonus, we didn't get it, because I believe Impala polished up their socks. And I believe going into the next matches, I believe they're doing quite well.
Okay, absolutely. And I saw that when you scored your try, you seemed to be slightly in disbelief. Was it something that you had expected, or did you not expect the line to come to you so easily?
Considering that I knew, the Impala knew that we were a set of good forwards, I believe I was expecting them to defend that set of forwards really well, but when it rolled really, really quickly, I didn't expect it to be that easy. Yeah.
All right. Now, we know that you're going to face off against the Western Bulls next weekend. What do you expect?
Them being at home, I believe it's going to be quite a tough match, because I believe they've not lost a match at home. So I believe going into Western Bulls, going to Kakamega, it's going to be really, really tough for the boys, and I respect the best discipline for the boys as coming into this match. You are beating discipline as we saw a yellow card in the 9 minutes of the match. Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, thank you again and congratulations.
Cheers.
We hope to see you, of course, victorious in
Cheers.
Western
thank you.
Next
thank
weekend.
Thank you. Cheers, man.
Now, joining me is Impala captain, Duncan Ekasi. And welcome, Duncan. Now, coming out from that match, we see that you guys did put in a lot of effort, especially in the second half. Well, what do you have to say? What do you think that, what was your expectations coming into this game and your result right now? How does it feel?
I think when we came to the game, our main idea was
to cut off their maul, which is normally their only point. But in the first half, I think a bit of miscommunication with the ref, so we really didn't get there. We ended up giving them tries. But if you say, as you've said, it's a case of two halves. In the first half, we let in those easy ones, but in the second half, they didn't manage to cross the white line. Though, even for us, we didn't even do much because we didn't go through also.
Absolutely. But I'd like to know what you guys talked about at halftime, because you guys came into the second half looking very strong, a lot more aggressive, a lot more passion in the second half. What did you say to the guys to get their spirits up?
Basically, at halftime, we agreed that no excuses. We can't blame the ref. We just come back and play 40 minutes of hard rugby. Where it gets us, good enough. But let's just come in, put in a 40-minute worth of yourself.
Exactly. Yeah. And thank you so much.
Thanks.
We hope to see you on top next weekend.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you so much. Joining me next, Impala Saracens coach Frank Ndong. Welcome. Good to see you.
Good to see you too, man.
Now, as we do know that you are one of Kenya's scrummaging gurus.
Yeah.
And scrummaging a team that you have played with, played against some of the players. What did you expect coming into this game against KCB, being that you guys have a history of beating KCB time and time again?
Yes. Actually, scrummaging was one of our stronger points this season. First half, we had a few injuries, so we lost part of our bulk, and KCB actually dominated the set pieces the first half. Second half, we made a few adjustments, technically, tactically, and I believe that worked, and at least we were able to hold our set piece and dominate theirs.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Now, coming into the second half, we noticed that there was a lot more aggression in the boys, a lot more passion, a lot more determination and urgency to every breakdown. What was the driving point for that? What did you put in them, other than what Duncan has just told us of no excuses and put in 40 minutes of worth of yourself?
Oh, first of all, the moral is the strong point. We had to sort that out. We had a bit of miscommunication first half. We got it wrong defensive-wise, and that's why they managed to score, I think, 3 tries from the mall. Now, we sorted that second half. Then they also had a problem. They were really slowing down our balls. We managed to get a faster ball out, and at least we were able to have a bit more possession. Earlier on, we had a slow ball. They were able to press us, and they're always on the back foot. Without the ball, you can't do much. You can't win.
As we do know.
Yeah.
But looking very good in the second half, what do you expect going into next weekend's game?
As difficult. Same thing, Nakuru are also quite good, the forward play, back play, defense, offense, an all-rounded team. I think one of the most all-rounded team in the country. So we have to switch on all departments, especially the forwards, because the forwards have to come to the bash. Without the forwards, honestly, we'll concede 5 points and tries. Yeah.
Well, all the best on that one. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
And we hope to see you again very soon.
Drawing boards on Monday.
Okay. All right. You. Take care.
Santé.
And finally, joining me is this match, Kenya Cup Match Day 5's man of this match, Jonah Henda, who's going to join me now. Congratulations.
Cheers, man.
And well in on that one. Seeming to look on form very well. I kept saying up there in the commentary box, I'd like to know how many meters you've run with that ball, because you kept picking it up and running and running and running. It's looking very good for you, as we do know that you've been on a very strict fitness regime. Your agility is looking good, your form is good, your strength is outstanding. Is this what you expected from this game, or did you get more than you had bargained for?
Oh man, I was a bit scared for the game. I knew Impala beat us last season.
Yeah.
Floodlights, they brought in their A game. We weren't going to take a no for an answer this time. We decided to focus, train 4 times this week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So guys were up to it. So I thank the park. They laid a platform for me. Yeah. I knew they were scared at some point when I started hitting them. So I just had to get on that courage and gain more meters for our team as a result.
And going into next weekend's game, do you think that you guys will be able to keep the same tempo, or will it be a bit tougher?
Oh man, Western is a tough team. Especially in their place, everyone is at home, schools have closed, they'll call on their boys.
Yeah.
We'll bring it to them, straight up. Last season they nearly beat us. We were the only team who beat them last season by 2 points. Mm-hmm. We need to get a bonus in Western. That's the only way forward.
All right. Once again, congratulations. Looking excellent out there. And we do know that we will be expecting more from you. You
of
do
course.
Know that we will be doing
yeah,
this.
Yeah, everyone expects more from the rest.
So keep it up and all the best.
Cheers, man.
All right. Yes. Thanks. Now joining me for a brief commentary at the moment, a brief analysis of this match, is Kenya Sevens, Biko Adema and current Nondis.
Hey,
welcome,
yeah.
Biko.
Thank you.
I'd shake your hand, but I have to be gentle.
Politely, yes.
I have to be gentle.
Yes.
Now, You did a lot of watching of that game. You did some good analysis of it. I'd like to know what you thought of that game on both sides, the second half especially, because that's when Impala came into it. That's when they brought themselves to the party.
Well, I think KCB, first of all, had the upper hand, man. You know, they were dominating from the get-go. They were pushing the Impala forwards and backs, always in the racks. They were dominating the racks, in the tackles, taking them backwards over and over again. Impala picked off lately in the game. You know, as I said, there were flashes of brilliance from players like Nyanjom, Nyandigisi, Oliech. But, you know, those flashes didn't
materialize. Materialize didn't turn into much, something, you know, that they needed.
And so that's why I think KCB just had the upper hand. And in the second half, blew it off. Blew Impala away. I mean, Alan Omuka had a big game, and as well as John Henders, we just seen.
Absolutely. Now the next game taking the pitch is going to be Total Nondies. Of course, your home side, very passionate about it. I've never seen you in any other jersey except that in Kenya. Taking on the Mighty Queens, who are on their home ground. Of course, it's not a Saturday, it's a Friday, Jamhuri Day, but it's a big day. Nevertheless, game day is game day. What do you expect from this game? Who do you think is going to come out on top and why?
Well, look, yeah, I expect a very exciting game. You know, basically we have two of Kenya's top teams, you know, as in their histories are amazing in this country. So, and you know, their past history between the rivalry between these two teams is very big. So, Queens on their home ground, obviously, they might think they have the upper hand, but it's still going to be a tough game to call. We expect to see a lot of exciting rugby. Both forwards, we know both teams are very forward-oriented.
Exactly.
And we just want to see an exciting game by the backs as well, you know.
Absolutely. As I do know, Nondi's over this the past few this year, you guys have had some backline tricks up your sleeve. Is that going to be materialistic here today?
Well, speaking from last week's game, I mean, guys like Charles Kanyi had an excellent game last week. He was the man of the match. So we know him as a very, very good passer of the ball, a very good stepper, and he's a good thinker. So we are hoping that we can get these type of players playing that integral role in this game.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much. I think it's time that we head back to our post and let the game continue. But thank you so much for joining us.
Cheers.
All right. Now that's what we have right now. Coming up next, we have Total Nondies taking on the Mighty Harlequins. We hope that this is going to be a match just as exciting or more exciting than what we've had. So back to the studio.